welcome back to my channel. I'm Jessica, the head witch of Bahati Life Apothecary. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today we're gonna be talking about the week ahead, and I have to honestly pace myself because there are so many important aspects and things that are happening here. I'm seeing this total explosion of energy that's happening, which is crazy because the planets are sitting in earth signs for the most part. Earth and water signs, but I can't help but to see earth and fire and blood. Yes, blood, I'm not kidding, and I'll talk about that in a minute as we dive into the chart a little further. Before I get started, I do want to give a little shout out to Forever 21. They don't sponsor this video at all, but I have to say that this past weekend I took a break from the apothecary and just doing all the things that I'm currently doing to see what Forever 21 had as far as seasonal stuff. I was keeping my fingers crossed for Halloween items, and I came across this sweater, which is really a long sweater to the point where it almost looks like a robe, and I have not taken it off since I bought it. It only cost me, I think, about $21 or $27, I can't remember, but I personally, as a Virgo, I like to get things on sale. I bought it full price, but I would buy it five times over in five different colors if I could. But at the time of me going, they had it in black and camel. But I just had to say it because this is easily one of my favorite items so far for the fall season. And we're not even in fall yet, but I'm already thinking about my favorites. And I was thinking about doing a favorites video for the fall season if you guys wanted to see that. If you do, give me a thumbs up or hit the comments down below, and I'll be more than happy to talk about my favorites currently, because this is definitely one of them. And I have another one that I've just been raving about that's been like a life changer. It's not a sweater, it's something else, but just FYI. That being said, let's go ahead and dive into this video. So the first thing that I have to say that I've been seeing and feeling is this energy of the power of your words, number one, the power of visualization. So these are the aspects of the planet Mercury, which makes sense, and I'll explain why. But I'm also seeing the magic that comes from that and actual materialization. I'm actually seeing like these particles, like these things kind of falling together and making themselves present in your life. This is not you setting intention for things. These are things that you have already started to process, that you started to think about, that you've been speaking into existence, that you've been writing down, manifesting, working your magic. And all of these pieces are like little particles that are coming together and are materializing in front of our eyes as we speak. And I truly believe that everything happens with perfect timing. And for that, I'm always looking at the stars. I'm always looking at what's going on in the cosmos, because that's when I can see when the energy is going to change and shift so that I can match and be prepared for what is to come and what is happening around me. The last few weeks, we saw this shift as planets moved into such earthy signs and emotional signs. For example, Venus moved into the sign of Scorpio the day of the new moon that happened in the sign of Virgo. Venus shows the aspects of love, attraction, and beauty, but she shows the things that it is that we are naturally gravitating towards, that we can't help but to find aesthetically pleasing, and the things that we want to invite into our life. Now, Jupiter is already sitting in the sign of Scorpio, and Jupiter has been working to kind of expand and expose and bring into your life things of higher quality. Sometimes we can see that right away, but when Venus moves in, these are things that are kind of pushed into our face now. We see it here and now. When Venus moved into the sign of Scorpio, what it is that we're going to see is this shift in what we're naturally attracted to, despite where Venus falls within your chart. We also watch how beauty changes, the aesthetic changes, and how our love kind of deepens or becomes more superficial. It's how we express this affection. It's how we express this love. When Venus moves into the sign of Scorpio, I mean, my goodness, the chart is so cozy. Just looking at it, it's so cozy. This is when she wants to share her time intimately with one person, one specific person, or a few specific things that mean the most to her. And that's what I'm seeing when I'm looking at the chart, is I'm seeing this grounded energy. I don't know where you guys are at or what you're going through, but currently in my area, the weather has really shifted from being warm to cold, and that's why I just find myself getting cozy, preparing for fall. I'm also gonna be migrating down to New Orleans, but I'm hoping that it gets really spooky and chilly down there while I'm down there so I don't miss the fall season, but we'll see what happens. As we watch Venus move into this intimate, intense, passionate, loving, wanting to dive into the deep of your partner, into the deep of yourself, sign of Scorpio, we're going to see a shift in how we experience and share love. And I love this because the chart is so sexy right now. In fact, one of the major words that came through as I was pulling the chart and preparing for the week ahead was tantric and tantra. Tantra is using the power of the mind and the body together cohesively in order to create an experience that is spiritual and also on a deeper level of intimacy. As I'm focusing on the week ahead, I go into a meditative state where I think about the energy of what's to come. I pull the chart and I allow messages to come through to me and through me. The majority of the personal planets can be found in earthy signs, grounded signs, and this is very slow, deliberate, and intentional. Then I see Jupiter and Venus moving into the sign of Scorpio. Scorpio connects so wonderfully to the energy of Tantra and Tantric practices. And that's essentially what it is that this chart is suggesting, is that we're taking these experiences, our regular everyday experiences, to the next level. We're deepening them. Now, I don't want you guys to hear me say Tantra and Tantric practices and then think that this is going to be like the sexiest week of your life. Now, the potential is definitely there if you know how to work your magic, if you know what I mean. For most of us, and for a lot of us, I would like to see you guys use this week, especially with this new moon falling in the sign of Virgo, to bring more quality experiences, people, relationships, content, awareness into your life. This is, again, it's slow, it's deliberate, it has intention behind it. There's a reason for everything. This is being very mindful and aware of your actions, your words, your mind, your body, your soul, your spirit. All these things are connected together. It's wild too, because Virgo is known for being virginal and pure, and that is true, but when we look at the energy of being virginal and pure, what Virgo is saying is not that you are without pleasure or without touch experiences or intimacy, but you're just making sure that the things that are coming into your life are of quality and worth your energy exchange. That includes relationships, the work that you do, the foods that you eat. We want to make sure that anything that is coming into your aura, into your vibe, has a worthy cause for being there. And if not, Virgo is the first sign to kind of cut those loose ends, because Virgo will not allow and accept anything that is subpar. Then, as I'm looking at the chart, I am watching the fact that Mars ruling our action, our drive, our ambition, how it is that we work to accomplish and to achieve things, and also our sexual energy and our expression, is moving into the sign of Aquarius. Now, Aquarius is known for being independent and detached, but more than anything, Aquarius wants to do things differently. It wants to strike out from the norm in a lot of ways. So what it is that I'm seeing is a focus on purification, manifestation and materialization, intention, quality over quantity, and the act of bringing in a new practice, a new routine, a new regimen into your lifestyle, into your day-to-day. The last few weeks/months, when we saw Jupiter and Neptune lock into this really beautiful trine, we started to feel ourselves getting very inspired. What I am seeing is this shift globally and people trying to find more meaning and substance in their life, but definitely for my tribe. The new moon was on the 9th, which was, for me, at the time of me filming this was yesterday, but the energy is going to be building up all week and getting stronger and stronger and stronger. I really want to encourage you guys to be very deliberate in your intention, in everything. Your breathing, your mind, the words that you speak. You have to realize too that Mercury is the planet of manifestation, and Mercury is the planet of alchemy and the magician, the ultimate magician, and not just like tricks of the eye, but like actual changing things for a higher purpose, changing things for a reason. Materializing something up out of nothing. It's like conjuring. That's what it is that we're doing. When Mercury is being activated all over this chart, with Mercury moving into the sign of Virgo, the sign that it naturally rules, and the Virgo new moon. When we look at the entire chart, there's something that is exploding here. There's something that is happening that is so deep within our bones. The other thing that I feel, and I don't know who this is or where this is coming from. I don't care how you normally come across. It almost feels like someone is like has a vibration go through them. Like they're like riveted. That's, maybe riveted is not the right word, but there's like, what I'm seeing is kind of this, it's this energy that comes through and ripples throughout your entire being, and it shakes you to your core. And what this is and what it is that you're feeling, it will make you nervous, it will make you scared, it will make you kind of close up for a minute or be like, what the hell was that? That's what this new moon is doing, and that's what this new moon has done. And what I'm seeing is, with the new moon and the way that the planets are situated, I'm seeing a person kind of rise up into their personal power and step into their personal power. They have to do things differently. The way that they have to walk might be different than what they have done up until this point. And that can very well be terrifying. That can very well be scary, but it's there for a reason. It's there to bring more purpose and meaning into your life through your experiences and through your relationship. This is new territory that it is that we're stepping into. Now, it was all fun and games when we were sitting down and we're thinking about our intention, we were asking for the universe to answer us and to bring these things into our life. But now that we start to see this path kind of unfolding, it's something is expected of you, and that can be enough to scare even the strongest person. The morning of the new moon, I woke up and the first thing that I thought was, Jess, you need to talk about mantras. You need to think about words. You need to tell them about the power of their own words that it is that they're saying. They are thinking that when you set intentions, that when you write these things down, that things will manifest. They also need to be reminded that they have to reset themselves. They have to put a spell on themselves. And the way to do that is by using specific mantras, by speaking life into yourself. Your physical body might be tightened up. You might have fear. You might have anxiety. And that's all normal. You might have doubt. You might not know what to expect. So your physical body can get nervous, which is natural, but you on a spiritual level know that there's something bigger that is happening and bigger that needs to happen to you and around you. And this is 100% connected to your destiny and the things that it is that your heart truly desires, to your core, like through your flesh, through your bone, through your blood. So this is when you use your words, the same words that you use to set an intention and to materialize things into your life. You use them and put a spell on yourself in order to speak life into yourself and to change your internal circumstances to match external circumstances. The words that were coming through are for my female population and also my men, but so much for my female population. I am one with my soul. I am one with my soul. I am one with my soul. Now, if you sit with that and think about that for a minute, what that is saying is that your words, your thoughts, the core of your being is connected so much to your soul. Your soul is connected to the divine. Your steps, your words, your heart, your thoughts, your intention, everything is connected to the divine and is speaking to you every single day. And the path unfolds according to that, which means that you are never derailed, you are never lost, but you do need to step into your personal power. You do need to feel strong. You do need to recognize the power and the force of your own personal being. There is one last thing that I want you guys to be aware of, and that's this weekend. I think that this weekend has the potential to be really magical and fun for a lot of people, and a good time to meet up, to connect, especially when it comes to exploring arts, love, creative projects, going out, having a good time. But it looks like when Venus sits directly opposite Uranus, this can really create a conflict. It can create like weird dynamics that are revealed in relationships, especially things that have been lying dormant or that have been happening for a while. It's weird as I'm looking at it because I can't tell if this is gonna be positive or difficult, challenging for some people. For some, it might be positive. For others, it might be challenging. Uranus, again, is kind of kicking up the dust when it comes to security and structure and stability for ourselves when it's sitting so low within the chart. And then Venus is trying to probe and to get to a deeper level when it comes to experiences and intimacy and connection and attraction. And when the two of these two come together, well, when they oppose each other in this way, it's kind of like, you know, the sky is the limit. We don't know what is going to happen here. We don't know what's going to happen. And that's kind of what always happens with Uranus. You never really can put your finger quite on what Uranus has in store. What concerns me is, as I'm looking at the chart and as I'm looking at my intuition, I feel like whatever, if it's negative or difficult or challenging, it's something that's kind of been swirling in the cosmos for a little while now that you might have had a sniff of, but now it kind of makes itself known, especially when the new moon is happening here. Some new door and some new portal has been opened. The good thing is that on the flip side, I can see this being a really spontaneous phenomenal week for new love, new romance, for the most part, for getting together and for meeting, which is good. Keep your fingers crossed for that. The problem is, and I hate that this is happening, is the fact that Mercury sitting in the sign of Virgo, which is trying to understand things. Mercury sitting in the sign of Virgo kind of overly analyzes stuff. So it kind of finds that it's in its head a lot, it's overthinking, and that can create a lot of trouble, a lot of problems when it comes to connecting with others and also interpreting what others are saying and what others are doing, especially this weekend when Neptune is sitting in the sign of Pisces. Neptune is known for kind of clouding the truth and clouding reality. What we hear and what we see, we have this way of kind of perceiving it, you know, differently than what it is. Like someone, it almost reminds me of when someone says something and there's five people that hear the same thing, but they just hear it different messages, or they pick up on different tones. That's essentially what it is that I'm seeing this weekend. So I really want you guys to kind of check in with people and check in with how it is that what you think someone's saying. I wouldn't be embarrassed, or I wouldn't hesitate to ask someone, okay, I don't really know what you mean by that. Like, what are you saying? When you said this, what is it that you're saying? I don't understand. I encourage you going the extra mile with trying to understand where someone is coming from before you jump to conclusions, especially with Venus sitting directly opposite Uranus. You just don't want to have like a rash reaction when it comes to someone that you like, or someone that you're getting to know, or if you're in a relationship already, like a long lasting relationship or a marriage or even short term relationships. There's just this potential to kind of break off and to split off. The other thing that I want you guys to be very careful of is that if you are deciding on making major changes to your appearance when it comes to aesthetic, because that's what happened when Venus moves into a new sign, we kind of find ourselves being like, ooh, I want to try something new and different. And that's so crazy that I'm saying this out loud, because I literally had this conversation this morning, and as I'm saying it, I'm like, you're doing it, Jess, you're doing it. So funny. But anyways, when Venus moves into the sign of Scorpio, or just moves into a different sign in general, we want to kind of change our appearance in a lot of ways, or change what we like, change what we love, switch things up a bit. I just think that if you do something spontaneous and different, this is not the weekend to do it. Not that I'm saying that it'll backfire, but there's people are cloudy mentally. They're not going to understand what it is that you're trying to say. And if you do have to do a major change, I also want you guys to be aware that Venus is going to go retrograde soon. And not that we're in her shadow period, but I can honestly say that it's just too close to comfort for me when it comes to cementing anything concrete during this time. When it comes to relationships or beauty and aesthetic, but just take your time, go slow and steady. I've been seeing that a lot within charts with my clients. I keep telling them to take your time. Please take your time. Please take your time. If this is what it is that I'm seeing now, and I see the potential of the relationship, or I see the potential of this happening, I don't want you to come to me 2 months, 3 months down the line, and then you say, Jess, I don't know what happened. I got so excited. You said that this was going to happen, and then I just started getting everything together, and then I asked him what he was thinking, what he was feeling, and then it all backfired, and now he's pulling back. And it's just like, girl, I literally told you to take your time, which means to just take it one step at a time. Stop forcing things. Why would you hear me tell you what it is that you need to do in order to allow this to keep unfolding in the way that is awesome, and then you hear that and run with it and, you know, smash into his face like everything that is that you want, and now he's terrified? Of course he's terrified. Of course. So anyways, that's again what it is that I'm seeing this week, and I just want you guys to be aware. I don't want any of my tribe to come in next week and say, I couldn't wait, I was so impatient. If you're impatient, you need to, again, slow your roll. Go back into taking deep breaths, especially this like tantric practice of intention and sensuality and depth and intimacy. It's nothing that should be rushed. It's nothing that should be forced. It's developed over time. And the more that you set the intent to connect with it on a soul level of just complete intimate sharing, whether it be with a person or a career or your purpose or whatever it is, then the more that you're going to benefit from it versus you just coming in and sledgehammering it. All right, my loves, I hope that that made a lot of sense. If you have any questions, comment them down below. Thank you so much for watching, subscribing, commenting, and sharing. Everything makes a difference. If you hit the thumbs up button on my channel or leave a comment down below, that definitely makes a difference, and it encourages and fuels the energy of the YouTube channel and the Bahati Life tribe here, our Bahati Life community. So I encourage that. And until then, I'll see you in my next video. I love you. Bye.